2 months from now, I have an appointment to play chess against a famous Dutch YouTuber called Dylan Haegens. Don't ask me why, because even I don't know. Last week I met him, and he bet me I couldn't beat him in a game of chess. And he was right. Or was he? See, I most likely won't be able to beat him with my experience with chess. But I most likely will be able to beat him with my experience with engineering. So I was thinking, what if we spent the next 2 months building an unbeatable chess machine out of Lego brick? But I wanted to be not too obvious. So a giant robot arm to move the pieces? No, we needed to be hidden and magical. So let's discuss the plan, shall we? My plan was to have all the mechanisms underneath the chessboard so that it would be really neat and magical. Unfortunately, we need to know where Dylan moves the chess piece so that the machine can react to it. I think the best way to do this is by hanging a camera above the board overlooking all the pieces. We'll figure out how to use it later. For the magical movement, I was thinking about using magnets to move pieces. If we attach a magnet to the bottom of the black pieces, we can move them using a different magnet under the board. This means we need some sort of moving mechanism that can move along the X, Y, and Z axis. We can release a piece by moving the magnet away. And I was all the functionality to play, but we need some way to win. If you're not familiar with chess, the only way to win is by knocking out the opponent's king. You can knock out other pieces to make it easier for you to win. You hear that? Knocking out other pieces makes it easier to win. And I want to win against a famous Dutch YouTuber. So let's just move the chess pieces to a slide so that they can slide off. With our plan done, I think it's time to build. The first thing we need is a chess board. The only problem is that this is a checkers board. So when you align the chess pieces, you see that there are two empty spaces on each side. This is because a checkers board has 100 squares and a chess board is 64 squares. But I know a way to solve this problem. You simply flip the board because there is a chess board on the other side. When we align the pieces right now, you can see they fit perfectly. Okay, sorry, let's move on. I removed the board from the chessboard so that the pieces would be able to slide off easily. It's exactly the same height as a Lego plate, which might come in handy. The bottom of the chess pieces are magnetic, so we can stick a magnet to it. When we grab another magnet and place it underneath the chessboard, we can move the magnet and thereby the chess piece. This gives us the magical movement instead of having to use a chunky robot arm. Now the problem with using a tiny magnet is that the pieces are unstable. Plus, the magnet isn't fixed in place and could come loose. To fix this, I cut circles out of cardboard to attach to the pieces. In the middle, there's a hole for the magnet and the cardboard stabilizes the piece. With the board and the pieces all done, I think it's time to get Lego involved. Unfortunately, the board isn't completely straight. Because of this, we can't simply slap the magnet onto a stiff mechanism, because the machine will break itself trying to move up or not even get there at all. I want to use rubber bands, but they would just slide up the magnet. So I glued a hook onto the magnet with hot glue to stop the sliding. Now it's stopped. Wait, let me quickly do this and the... As I said, now it stops the rubber band from sliding up the magnet and we have a way to compensate for the bent board. After slicing away some of the wood because it was just a little too big, I embedded the board in Lego pieces. I also added a slide that didn't work because the diagonal pieces aren't compatible with the straight magnet mechanism. To solve this, I tried a spring-loaded platform to eventually settle on a motorized trapdoor. The downside of using a motor though is that you also need a cable. And the longest cable I have is 50 centimeters. So let's order off-brand cables that are twice as long. Wait, what? Correction, the longest cable I have is 1 meter if you include a big file. You see, Mindstorm's cables are basically the same as phone cables, but with a different clip to hold it in place. Me being me, once foolishly ordered regular phone cables to then realize they don't fit. But today, we're changing that by removing some of the clip. It does mean that it isn't held in place by the clip anymore, so we have to hold it in place with Lego. After all, I'd say this is a pretty good solution and it is exactly the right size. Next, we're working on all the axes. The Y axis will consist of two gear racks with a larger X axis running over it. The X axis will need to be a small mechanism with the Z axis attached to it. It can stick out more than 7 studs to any side or else it will hit the walls near the edges. If we encase this all in Lego, we should have a working mechanism. You can see the queen magically moves across the board without any visible mechanism. Correction, you can see the queen magically moves across the board with the visible mechanism because I ran out of bricks for the walls. So let's order some new Lego bricks and while we wait for them to come, we can address the cables of the moving mechanism. Unfortunately, even the longest cables from Mindstorms are still too short, so we're getting the other 3 phone cables involved and I customized them all. While working on the cables, I accidentally dropped my fan onto the Lego, and when I put everything back together, I had 2 pieces left over. I guess if something breaks, we'll know why. Now let's finish the bottom, shall we? To add some more to the design, I made Lego chess icons to embed in the front wall. After this, I made sure to make everything the right height and connected the board to the walls. I also tried a new idea to get pieces off the board, which I scrapped after 8 attempts because the white pieces don't even have magnets underneath them, so the mechanism can't even move them closer to the side. The last thing to tackle is the camera to monitor the board. I made a large ball to then realize it was so big that it didn't fit a frame. But after aligning the camera so that it can see the entire board, I think the mechanical machine is finally done. I just feel like this machine is missing just a little bit more magic. It's basically a big box after all. You know what screams magic? Harry Potter. Oh, I know what you want. Or actually, I know what I want, but let's just assume you want the same thing. The final product. With the machine done, you know what time it is. Programming time! You start the program when you've set up the chess pieces in the correct order. The program will now take a picture of the board and wait for any changes. As soon as it detects that the frame is now different from the first picture, it knows that you are making your move. As soon as you have made your move, it takes a new picture and compares the two. The difference between the images informs the computer about which move you made, after which the move is fed into a chess engine. After this, the engine returns its move and lets the player know if they need to remove any pieces off the board. After potential removals have been executed, it translates the digital move in a physical way. The computer now tells you it's done and that you can go ahead and make a new move. Notice that when moving the pieces, it moves along the edges of the squares so that it can move between pieces standing in its way. It always chooses the side that is the furthest away from the outer edge because the pieces can't move along the outer edge. This is why sometimes moves might not make sense, but it's just an easy way to prevent it from stalling. There is one slight problem with the camera system. Because it is hanging pretty close to the board, the pieces look distorted and don't actually just fit inside the spaces. Because of this, a move could be seen as only one difference. But I won't let that stop me. I programmed it so that whenever it covers a large space with only one difference, it picks two spots, depending on the position on screen. This assures that your move will always be registered correctly. These 527 lines of code make it so that you can play chess against a Lego machine.
That is going to be tested right now.
Stan, what is this?
It's a chess machine.
I was going to play chess against you.
Yes, that's right, but we'll do it like this. I'm technically still playing against you. I made it, so just deal with it, okay?
Let's go, man. Yeah, sure. I'm really good at chess, so yeah. I even put on my chess playing shoes.
Wow.
I can't lose with these, so be prepared.
Yes, I will. Are you ready?
No. Okay. I don't know what's going to happen. Is it going to explode or something? Do I get a pie in my face?
I hope it's not going to explode, but okay. I can't guarantee anything.
Okay.
I shall start the robot and you go first.
Alright, I'll start with the pawn.
It's detected that you move the pawn and it's going to move it.
Oh, shit.
What?
What is this? Alright, this is kind of scary.
It's your move again, so...
Okay. I'm gonna move the knight.
I shouldn't do that, that's why I were you, but...
Why not? This is the best move ever.
Okay, we'll see.
Alright.
I thought really hard about that move.
Yeah?
Yeah,
I saw it.
I thought really hard
I saw
about
steam
that
coming out
yes
of your ears. Yeah. Now I got you, man.
Yeah?
Okay. No, I don't think so. Let's go. Aggressive moves, you know? Oh. I got an idea! Let's go.
Please remove
E4. That's this one.
Yes. Okay. What was your plan? You just lost the piece.
No. Please remove your king. Good try.
Yeah, it blocked it. I blocked it.
Didn't expect this one. Let me see.
Interesting.
Yeah, very interesting. What's happening here? No. I thought I had an idea. No, but oh, man! So hard.
You're not going to win this.
Oh, you have to think very long.
I usually take like 5 seconds. F7.
No! It was just there! Come on, man! Leave it alone! Come and get me!
You shouldn't forget about the king. It's pretty important in chess, you know?
No. I'm gonna do this.
Do it.
Mm-hmm.
Sure.
Stan.
Sure.
Come on.
You have to do something.
Yeah, I know, but... Harry Potter!
Harry Potter.
Your move.
I think there's only one move, but I need to do this.
You lost.
Oh, you lost.
You lost!
Winning. H4 to F2.
No, man, but...
You can't make a move that doesn't kill you, basically.
I was so aggressive at the beginning.
Yeah, you shouldn't have been, because you lost 3 pieces. And the machine only lost one pawn.
Yeah, but sometimes you need to lose something to win something, you know?
But maybe not 3 times as much as the machine.
Yeah, well played, man. Well played. I couldn't do anything. Did we had a bet or something?
No,
Alright, alright.
I'll spare you this time.
Next time when you build a robot, I'm gonna win from it.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yeah, yeah, of course. Yeah.
Okay, I don't believe it.
You know what? I'm hungry for more. I want to be my dad as well. So, don't mind me. I'm just going to casually beat my dad.
It lost.